The honu is a key aspect of Hawaiian culture. You see it in petroglyphs and stories of Aumakua, the individual guardians of Hawaiian people. In fact, green sea turtles go back over 100 million years before the dinosaurs. But a modern disease, fibropapilloma, or FP, is threatening these ancient survivors. It is a serious virus that can sometimes be deadly.
The fibropapillomatosis was first discovered in Kaneohe Bay in 1957, first published about it in 1958. But it was actually first discovered in Florida in 1938. You know, imagine if you're swimming around with a big thing on your head, something that obstructs your vision, because that's generally where it starts, in the posterior of the eye, and then it kind of grows elsewhere as well. If you see a turtle with the tumors on the outside, a lot of times that they have tumors on the inside as well.
Although there's mystery surrounding the direct cause of FP, aquatic biologists believe the disease occurs in geographic areas that have been compromised by man-made pollutants, such as here on the north shore of Maui.
The virus, I believe, has also a condition of the environment. With our environment, we have a lot more fertilizers and a lot more runoff and things. The tumors appear to be induced but also by a lot of nutrients. And so for Maui, we've had nutrients coming from land sources like the injection wells as well as runoff.
While nutrients such as nitrogen may be good for plants on land, in the water, they only feed invasive algae and cause algae blooms.
And then so when the turtles eat the introduced algae, they're also ingesting a lot more nitrogen, and that may be tumor-inducing.
Howe believes one solution to this growing problem is to protect another endangered part of our environment, the wetlands.
And that's where our wetlands become more important, because the wetlands would help hold back the runoff that would normally just flow into the ocean. And the wetlands and the recycling of nutrients and things with plants. We as a community have to look where our nutrient source is coming from and not apply so much fertilizer. But we're still going to have to still address where our sewage goes.
So what can you do to help the honu? Learn how to minimize your home use of fertilizers. Learn how you can help preserve Hawaii's wetlands. And if you do see a turtle that seems to be stricken with fibropapilloma, stay away.
You know, I just kind of want everybody to kind of put yourself in the turtle situation. Think about, you know, if you're sick, what do you want to happen? You know, you want to be able to rest. You want to be able to not be bothered by anything. So really just an overall respect for the turtles. If you see them swimming in the water, don't chase after them. If you see them basking on the beach, don't get too close. They're trying to sleep. And if they're trying to sleep, you need to really respect that. It is up to us to really help these turtles out, you know? If we are causing it, then it's up to us to really help them.
This is Alex Abraham reporting from Seabury Hall for HIKI Now.